I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself in order to strengthen a bond and to basically I do. Hold on, sorry, I'm going to adjust this. I don't know how I want this. I don't know if you guys want to see my face or not, but I'm going to just do what makes me comfortable. Hold on, just adjusting this just a little bit. Okay. So, today I am basically going to be telling you guys about myself. Currently, I'm not going to go into my history because I fucking hate thinking about my history. I hate thinking about the things that I don't want to remember. Currently, I'm in a huge state of paranoia. Just due to my past and just the things and the people I've associated myself with previously. So I'm trying my best to escape that realm of mind and that realm of thought in order to evolve into not only a teacher, but just someone to motivate the youth and to push the youth in a positive direction to be able to, not ideally like control, but to just manifest that type of energy. I want to see, like, I want to just have more power in the aspect of trying to, like, all right, I know what the kids want. I know what we all desire. I understand things, and I feel like that's why I've been placed in such an important position, because I understand things, and I just understand how people feel in the aspect of, okay, I know how it feels to be alone. I know how it feels to be around people and feel alone. Like, I'll be around a million people and I'll, like, still feel alone. Like, even sometimes, like, all right, like, I'll go out even with my own friends, like, my previous friends, and I just would feel alone. And I've just, like, you know, I'm in a position now where I was friends with a lot of people and I kind of felt abandoned. I've seen people choose material items over me. I've seen people choose status quo over me. I've seen people, like when you give them ultimatums, they just choose everything besides you. So I've just been placed in situations that are very heartbreaking as far as, like, people, period. So the only people that I've ever seen kind of suffice for me and offer me the support always is you guys, my people. You guys are my people, and I felt very attached to the, I don't want to call it a family, so I fucking hate that. I like to call it a cult. I like to call it a family. I feel attached to you guys as if you were my own family, even though I don't know half of you, even though I can't really be everything ideally I want to be for you guys, which I'm trying to be. I'm trying to assert myself. That's like, I hate, like, sounding like an egotistical motherfucker, but this is the closest I can get to. I'm trying to assert myself as some sort of prince, regardless of the stipulations around my name, regardless of all the negativity that I'm fed, regardless of how some people treat me. I've tried to put myself in a position to ideally be able to motivate others to, I mean, for myself to suffice when it comes to this negative shit, because, like, bro, this shit, it's like trying to consume me. It's almost like it's trying to get inside of my mind, you know? So I've started to look at myself very differently and beat myself up. And you guys are the only thing that gives me hope. You guys are the only things that thing that motivates me to ideally, like, yo, be strong. You have over 8 million kids or adults and teenagers watching you, relying on you for this hope. So I wanted to give a bit of advice. I wanted to give a bit of clarity. I wanted to give a bit of an explanation. Now, I'm winging this. This isn't written. There's nothing written here. Just so you know, I'm winging this whole video. So when I'm talking to you, I want you to know that this is genuinely from my heart. This isn't some bullshit pre-scripted motherfucking words coming off of a paper or anything. As you can see, you see that there's nothing behind me. Okay, so my current focus is creation and evolution. No matter whether you realize it or not, every day you evolve. Every day you create. You create in thought, you evolute in mind, you evolute as far as your age, you evolute physically, mentally. If you are evoluting physically and you are not evoluting mentally, you are not doing the right thing. So for you guys, I want you guys to constantly be trying to evolve. As far as creation, being creative in thought, being like living life like a dream, you know, like as far as you are the actor in your own movie, you get what I'm saying? And you are the person that you desire to be. If you want to be pretend to be a princess, carry yourself with the mannerisms of a princess. If you want to be a prince, carry yourself with the mannerisms of a prince. If you want to be, like, it's better not to be a crazy motherfucker. It's better not, because I've went through that. There was a point where I wanted to be the villain, and it's not fun, bro. It's not fun. People turn, like, it doesn't attract anything that you truly want. It's better to be respected through love rather than fear. It's better to be respected through, not to repeat myself. It's better to be respected through love rather than fear, simply because, like, all right, I was respected through fear. And it's not real love. It's not real love, and it drives people away. It makes people treat you differently. It makes people really, like, it's just not genuine. It's not what you really would want. So, I'm kind of lost with the subject matter. So to jump to love, because I'd like to talk about love, and it's always on my mind. I've really stopped looking for someone, unfortunately, because. Currently where my mind is, it's just like, I don't want to say I've given up, but I've just seen everybody make me promises and never really fulfill. Like, I was always looking for a caretaker, looking for someone that would protect me, take initiative for me, and just be the greatest person they could for me. And that may be selfish, I don't know, but that's just me being honest. And every time I've kind of let myself be led on by someone, they either deceive me or just treat me really, really, really bad. And I'm a very genuine person, and I'm far too emotional, and I care too much, and I've definitely cared too much in situations and been fucked over. So what I do want to say to my supporters and my family, as far as you guys, the key to love is compromise. The key to love is also loving yourself. Now, and love is a very complicated thing. Look at love like a game. Everything is a game. Look at love like a game. If, in order for your partner to respect you, you have to respect yourself. But in the same context, you also have to compromise for them. So it's a very complicated idea. So, like, all right, look at it this way. If your lover disrespects you, there is a certain way you have to, I can't tell you how to deal with it, but there is a certain way you have to deal with it, as far as, like, okay. Your lover says something to you you don't like. Instead of getting angry, instead of leaving, which is never the answer, because you'll never find love in leaving. That's pride. If you think with pride during your relationship, the shit won't work out. Because then it'll just be an egotistical battle. And, bro, I'm sorry to say it, women have far more pride than men. Men have pride, but women have pride, and it's hidden. But I respect women. I respect the woman's pride, because it's a different type of pride. You guys don't want to be walked on. You guys don't want to feel disrespected. You guys want to feel empowered. But in the same context, you guys have to understand, we look to women for emotion. We look to women for comfort. You know, to be grounded. Like, all right. Earlier on in my life, I didn't have my mom would try and financially take care of me, but my mom was going through it at a young age, so she wasn't really able to be there, and it wasn't her fault. And I didn't have a woman in my life to ground me emotionally, so I always looked to other people for emotion, and I always was disappointed, because obviously no one will be able to compromise for me fully, because I would give my all and put my all into things, and I would just never be compensated for the love I would give. So, as far as compromise, for one, don't put your pride in the fucking relationship. The shit doesn't work. It makes the shit harder than it needs to be. It makes it complicated. It makes everything hard. Do not put your ego in a relationship. Do not be afraid to blow up your lover's phone. It's the ones that are annoying that love you. It's the ones that will sit there and blow you up for hours and check on you 24/7 and annoy the fuck out of you that care. It's okay to be annoying. In order to... Okay. Now, another thing with love. Don't try and publicize... I'd say publicize your love in the same context. Like, show people you're happy. But when you start showing people what you've got going on in your personal life, that's when people feel the need to get involved, or people get in the middle and fuck everything up. Keep your relationship to yourself. That other shit in the middle fucks it up. Sometimes you can't ask for opinions. Sometimes you gotta battle the shit out for yourself. Like I said, it's like a game. So whenever you ask for someone else's opinion, it's almost like, look at it this way. They're dealing with something from a preconceived, they're dealing with it from a preconceived notion of what you told them. So they'll never understand the how much compromise your partner has given for you, and how much of a situation, how much care this has been put in the situation, you know? Because no one can ever really care about the person that you care about. Now, to jump away from love, to jump to purpose, no one can explain why you are alive. No one can save you but you. You have to put the mind into what you want to put the mind into. If you believe in something, you can achieve it. Now, that doesn't mean everybody needs to be a rapper. That does not mean everybody needs to be a fucking painter or an artist. That doesn't mean that way. Your art can be in your emotion. Your art can be in your mind. Now, you can be a doctor, and that can be a form of art. You can be a therapist, and that can be a form of art. It's how you articulate. You get it? Articulate. It's how you treat these things. It's the manner that you treat. You know what I'm saying? Even relationships and friendships can be a matter of art. It's a matter of mind. Now, purpose. Only you create your purpose. Now, trying to always impress others does not work. Now, with millions and millions of supporters and family and fans, and it, trust me, some motherfuckers will hit me up and be mad disappointed with some decisions I made, be mad disappointed with some music, and I've tried my best to impress or meet this standard, you know, always. Fuck that. Make yourself happy. If something makes you happy, follow it. Now, do not be toxic in that. Do not take my words and twist them and turn them negative. Do not be toxic. I want for everybody that follows me and supports me to make sure you are being healthy in mind, being caring, compromising for the ones you love, being loyal to the ones you love. Do not say you love me and be some motherfucker out here cheating on your people. Look. If you love someone, you're supposed to be dedicated to them, right? Now, I don't follow relationships simply because I don't want to promise someone something and then not keep my word because of how much I've been hurt. So I've been in a situation where I'll talk to people and I'll tell them, yo, I don't want to be involved with one woman because when I give my all to someone and they disappoint me, it makes me feel horrible. And it takes my very soul out of me. It breaks my fucking heart. So I don't know, man. It's hard to explain. I don't want to leave you guys without some sort of answer. So I'm just going to jump to this. Purpose. No one can create your purpose for you. No one can tell you who to be. There is no such thing. There is no such thing. No one can tell you who to be. So in purpose, you have to create your own purpose. And in evolution, you have to evolute towards that purpose. It's easier to live when you have goals to meet. You understand? If you have goals to meet, then you don't feel so voided, and you understand why every day you're looking at this person in the mirror, because that is the cool part about the game. You get to be anybody you want to be. Now, take that, please, and I hope the little words that I did say did motivate you, and I'm sorry if I didn't give you any sort of clarity. I was scatterbrained. Like I said, I winged this. I just simply wanted to speak to you guys, and I apologize for being so distant. I've been paranoid. I've been needing help, and I haven't been getting the ideal help I really want. So I apologize if I haven't been there enough, and I'm going to be vlogging more often. I probably might post another vlog after this. I don't know. I'll let you guys know. I'm going to be going to I'm going to be going to a homeless shelter and giving out some food, giving out probably some clothes. Then I'm going to probably go to I'm going to do this. Then I'm going to a foster home and probably like donating PS4s and video games and probably buying some beds or anything that's going to help out the local foster homes. But I'm just taking the time out to plan and to do the right thing and to show you guys that I am a people person and that I will be a good person for the community, and I will have ties to the community in the aspect of showing people that, hey, I'm going to put my mind towards actually helping the world in itself. With that being said, I love you guys. I appreciate you for all the love that you guys give me, and I appreciate you for giving me your attention. Oh, sorry. That's my motherfucking alarm.